In this tutorial, we will learn how to create this 3D object in AutoCAD 2020. At first, we will create this bottom plate. The size of this bottom plate is 60 by 70 plus this 30, that is 100. And thickness is 15. Click here, scroll down and select a CAD ISO template. Then to switch to 3D environment, click here and click on 3D modeling. Now here only X and Y axis is visible. To make Z axis visible, click here on unsaved view and select SE isometric. Then to remove this uses icon from here, click on this icon. Then take your cursor on this square blue grip, right click, then click on uses icon settings and click on show uses icon at origin. So it will shift it in the corner. Then click on rectangle, then specify first corner point. I will click here, take your cursor away. Then specify the size of rectangle. Our length in X direction is 60. So type 60, then comma, then length in Y direction is 100. Enter. Then zoom here. To convert this rectangle into 3D, click on press pull. Then select this rectangle. Take your cursor above and give the thickness of 15, enter and escape. Then to give it solid look, click here and select shaded with edges. Then next we will create this cut. The width of this cut is 20 and location from this point will be 30 and diameter of this circle will be 20. So zoom here, then click on line, then specify first point at this midpoint, take your cursor on this side and click on this midpoint, press enter, then click on offset, then specify offset distance of 10, enter, then select object to offset, click on this line. Then take your cursor on this side and click. Again select this line. Then take your cursor on this side and click. Press escape. Then to copy this edge at a distance of 30, take your cursor to this arrow near extract edges and click on copy edges. Then select this edge, enter. Then specify base point here in empty space. Then make ortho on. Take your cursor on this side and give the distance of 30. Enter. And click on exit. Exit. Then create one circle here. Click on circle. Center radius. Then specify center point for circle. Center point will be this midpoint. Click on it, then click on this intersection point. Then remove the unwanted objects, type E for erase, enter, then select this object and this object. Enter, then trim the unwanted portion for trim type TR, enter, enter. Then click on the objects to be removed. Enter. Then to create cut, we will again use press pull. Click on press pull. Then click inside this shape, take your cursor below and click and escape. So here this cut is created. To orbit, press shift, press middle mouse button and drag the mouse. Then to remove this line, type E, enter, select this object, enter. Then to go back to previous view, click here and select SE isometric. zoom minus. Then next is to create these fillets of radius 30. Click on fillet, then select this line, then enter fillet radius 30, enter, then orbit it and click on this line, enter, then again orbit it. Then next is to create this vertical portion. Now width of this plate is 15 and height is 65. Click on copy edges, select this edge, enter, specify base point, take your cursor on this side, then specify 15, enter, enter, enter. Then to convert this portion into 3D, click on press pull, click inside this rectangle, take your cursor above and give the height of 65, enter, then escape. Then next is to create this circular portion. The diameter of inside circle is 30, that is 15 radius. Click on circle, click on this midpoint. Now it is creating circle in top plane, but we want to create circle on this surface. Press escape. If you want to create something on this surface, then you will have to use front plane. And if you want to create something on this surface, then you will have to use right plane. So we want to create our shape on this face, therefore we will select front UCS. Click here and click on front. So here you can see that XY is vertical, and if you don't want to view this grid, you can turn it off from here. Click on it. Then click on circle, then specify this midpoint as center point, take your cursor away, then specify radius of 15, enter, then again specify this midpoint as a center point and click on this endpoint. So it will automatically catch that radius. Then to convert this into 3D, again click on press pull. Then click inside this portion, take your cursor on this side, and this total length is 50, and length from this surface will be 50 minus this 15, that is 35. Take your cursor on this side and give the length of 35, enter. Then press pull is still running, we don't want this internal portion, take your cursor on it, click. Take your cursor on this side and click and press escape. Then to remove these circles, type E, enter, then select these circles, enter. Then next is to create this rib. We know that this total width is 60, that means the diameter of this circle is 60, that means radius of this circle will be 30. Therefore, to work out height of this rib, we will have to minus that 30 from this 65. That means it will become 65 minus 30, that is 35, and plus this 15, that is 50. So height of this rib will be 50. Then we know that this length is 35. Then again this rib will be on the plane parallel to this surface. As we know, if we want to work on this surface, you will have to choose the right plane. Click here and select right, then click on line, click here, take your cursor on the right side, ensure that your ortho is on, then type 35, enter, take your cursor below, then give height of 50, enter, then click on this endpoint and press enter. Then to convert this triangle into 3D, click on press pull. Take your cursor inside this triangle, then click, then take your cursor on this side, give the thickness of 10, enter and escape. Then we will have to move it. For that, click on move. Select this object, enter. Then base point will be this midpoint. Click there, make ortho off, and click on this midpoint. Then erase this portion, type E, enter, select this object, enter. Then orbit it. Here you can view that there is some gap. To fill this gap, again we will use press pull. Click on press pull. Then select this horizontal rectangle, take your cursor above and click and escape. Now this portion and this portion are two separate portions. To join them, we will have to use union command. Here is solid union. Click on it. Then select this object and this object and press enter. So here it got connected. Then to assign some color to this object, double click on it. Then click here. Then click here and choose your desired color. Okay, and escape. So here this object is ready. So thanks for watching. We will stop here.